to welcome the Chicago State University Board of Trustees, who are here for the second annual Board of Trustees night. We thank you for your support. Let's take a look at our stat leaders at halftime. First for the UMKC Kangaroos. High point scorer at halftime is Martez Harrison with 9 points. And the high point rebounder is Nelson Kirksey with 5 rebounds. For the Cougars, the high point scorer for both teams at halftime, Quentin Pippen with 13 points on 3 of 3 from 3-point range. And the high point rebounder for the Cougars with 3 at halftime is Matt Ross. Thank you. Chicago State Cougars. To begin the second half, alternating possession arrow points to the Cougars. Basket by Eddie Denard. Basket by Fred Chapman. Come here. of bounds, last touch by the Cougars. Out of bounds, last touch by the Cougars. That's kicked by Eddie Denard. Basket by Frank Williams Jr. Three-point basket by Matt Ross. Three-point basket by Nelson Kirksey. Timeout called by the Roos. It's a full 60-second timeout. The women play their next home game on Thursday, February 13th against the Bronx of UTPA. That's Texas Pan American. Tip-off is at 7 p.m. The men will return to the Jones Convocation Center on Thursday, February 20th to host the Wolverines of Utah Valley. Game time on that game on February 20th is at 7.05 p.m. So Mike plans to join us here at the Jones Convocation Center for our upcoming men's and women's basketball games and show your support for Cougar Athletics. Out of bounds, last touch by the Roos.
and a smart player in Quentin Pippen.
Mm-hmm.
Foul's on.
Foul for Kansas City on number 40, Trinity Hall.
Yeah, he just has to stay down on that. You can't go for the fade. Just stand your ground. You're big. He's, what, 6'7"?
Oh, yeah.
Pippen's like 6'3". Just got to stay in ground and try to contest the shot.
Pippen at the line. First one's good. Second is good as well. Hall inbounds the ball over to Harrison. Harrison has Muhammad on him. And Rosenberg, it seems.
The Cougars come up and press themselves.
Nice steal.
Great steal by Muhammad over to Rosenberg.
Yes.
And a three-point play.
Now that particular play, Muhammad had got behind, came back up, put himself in the position on that next dribble to rip the ball. That was a good play on his part.
Regardless of what team you're rooting for, you're going to acknowledge how awesome that play just was.
Turning defense into offense.
Yes, yes. That's always a good look in any team. And if you're going to steal the ball, that needs to turn into points. The same way if you have a turnover, turn it into points. There's
right.
kind of no point of doing it and not following through. And so that was awesome that they were able to complete that play.
Yeah. And is it just me, or I believe that Muhammad, with his first game, he's really making a difference and he's impacting this game with his play on his on the defensive end and offensive end.
Yeah, he's definitely come out and he's proven, you know, why he's on the team and proven that he can make a difference. You know, with him coming out, I feel like it's just to the advantage of CSU. And so that's going to be a person that Kansas City is going to want to watch out for. You can never count really anyone on the bench out for CSU, because we've said that numerous times. You know, they all have their great advantages. And so Kansas City is the same way.
You know, you can't coach drive and speed.
Absolutely.
You know, that's something you got to have.
That's a great
and
point.
You know, and Muhammad looks like he's been there every game, like he started every game.
Yeah.
I mean, I think that's true with all the CSU players. The freshmen, you know, I haven't had the opportunity to see much of Kansas City, but they looked as well-tuned, you know, also. But for CSU, everybody, when they come out on that floor, they're part of that team.
Yeah. Kansas City has about five freshmen on their team, and it's almost crazy to think that number 54 Isaac Kruger is a freshman, 6'10". I don't know if you guys saw him earlier, but
yeah,
that's
big
one
boy.
Big old freshman.
Yeah, he's a big boy.
6'10". Jeez, what were you, like 5 foot when you were born? I'm sorry. Rosenberg at the line for CSU.
And, you know, I have that visual in my head.
I know. Came out my size, basically. And completed the three-point play there by Rosenberg. Harrison has the ball with Muhammad in his face. He's going to try to find someone. He finds Kirksey over to Hall. Hall over to Williams Jr. Back to Harrison. Harrison has bodies all over him.
Great defense, Chicago State.
Yeah.
Shut down every attempt.
Just a little over-aggressive. I think they call a foul on Quentin Pippen, his third.
Yep. And that's the first team foul on the Cougars in the second half. Kansas City with the ball. Stolen away by Pippen. And the pass was supposed to go to Muhammad, but it looks like it was kicked off of Harrison's foot there. The pass was just a little bit quicker than Harrison. Totally saw where he was going with that one, though. Yeah, Pippen's going to inbound the ball for CSU. Pippen over to Ross. Ross over to Rosenberg. Over to Pippen. Good look there by Ross for CSU.
You got to close that gap. If you give him a space, he will shoot it.
Absolutely. Current score is 48-33 with 15 minutes and 9 seconds left in the second half. Bledsoe with the ball for Kansas City. Muhammad on him. Passes wide open over to Kurtsey. He was wide open. No one even saw him there. Muhammad with the ball. No look pass over to Pippen. Back to Muhammad. Muhammad shoots the three. It's no good. Kurtsey there with the rebound for Kansas City. He brings the ball up the court. Muhammad in his face there. Kurtsey looking to penetrate and take it home himself. He loses the ball. Denard takes a dive, and Pippen has the ball.
That was a really good strip by Muhammad.
Yeah, over to Ross. Back to Muhammad, over to Pippen. Pippen takes the shot. It's no good. Bledsoe there with the rebound. Brings the ball up the court. Fast break.
Muhammad is just all over the place.
Bledsoe with the ball. 22 seconds in the shot clock. Looking for someone to pass it to. Lost the ball quickly. Passed it in to Chapman over to Kurtsey in the corner, who was open. But the foul was called. He was totally fouled. Was that by Pippen?
Yes, and I think that is his fourth foul, which takes him out of the game earlier, which is one of his, which is one of the CSU Cougars, their leaders on the court and one of their scoring, one of their leading scorers.
That's always their downfall, and I called it early in the game. I always get nervous for CSU because they get a lot of early on fouls, and so when it comes to second half, it kind of makes Dildy have to go to his bench. Not that it's a bad thing because, you know, his bench is, has proven that they're awesome players, but you never want your players to foul out.
Yeah.
And we're going to have Kurtsey at the line for Kansas City. We brought in DeMacos here for Pippen. And the free throw was good. Timeout is called. Or not.
That's just substitution.
Oh, I heard the whistle. I thought it was a timeout. All righty. Just quick substitution. DeMacos inbounds the ball to Rosenberg. Back to DeMacos. Over to Duhon. Duhon passes over to Ross in the corner. Over to Rosenberg. Rosenberg has Bledsoe on him. Over to DeMacos, Harrison on DeMacos, Williams Jr. on Duhon. Duhon back to Ross. Ross took the shot over Johnson, but it was no good.
You know, ladies, I'm feeling it. I'm something big is going to happen. One of these guys, something is going to be happening.
Hall inbounds the ball over to Harrison. Harrison has Rosenberg on him. Harrison up. Trying to pass over to Bledsoe. That's what I was going to call. Bledsoe with the ball. Duhon in his face. Passes back to Harrison. DeMacos on Harrison. Staying strong there. Harrison tipped it up. And the basket's going to count.
Way to take advantage of that hang time.
Foul called.
And this is going to be a momentum changer with Quentin Pimpin getting his fourth and then with them getting two back-to-back baskets.
The foul was on DeMacos. Harrison completes the three-point play in a quick substitution here, bringing in Burke.
Kansas City is increasing their size now.
DeMacos with the ball for CSU, slows it down, passes it over to Rosenberg. Rosenberg had two bodies on him. He finds Duhon, who's open. Duhon takes it home, tipped it in, and what looked like it was going to go in, but it bounced right back off the net.
Really good contest and really good defense
by Kansas City.
Oh, no, that should have been a foul. He was pushing off.
Williams Jr. with the ball, takes the shot, and it's good. Right over Matt Ross. Matt Ross didn't seem to really contest that one.
With shooters, the only thing they need is to see it go in a basket once, and he can get the goal. And this is the second shot that he's hit.
Rosenberg with the ball over to Duhon. Duhon back to Rosenberg, trying to set something up here. Dildy's calling out a play. Rosenberg to Duhon. Duhon inside pass to Denard. Denard back to Duhon. 8 seconds left on the shot clock. Over to DeMacos. DeMacos to Ross. Ross takes the shot. It's no good. DeMacos with the rebound. Loses the ball. Denard takes a dive on the ball. And on top of him was
Well, it looked like we got away with a little travel call, but did you see how Eddie jumped on that like it was a loose football?
Yes, absolutely.
With those are 50-50 balls. You have to win the 50-50 balls.
Yeah.
Because you get extra possessions, and it gets your team hyped just because you're diving on the floor to get the ball.
Kanika just tells us some things we never really knew.
It's that inside edition.
Right? And brief timeout here as both teams are in a huddle. Current score is 48-41. Kansas City is closing up that gap that they had earlier. We have 12 minutes and 14 seconds left in the second half. It's anybody's game. Everybody's about to come out of the huddle, and the game will continue. It will be CSU possession. Rosenberg will inbound the ball. Over to Karis. Karis has Bledsoe on him. Passes over to Duhon. Duhon's looking. Calling out a play here to someone. Duhon penetrates in. No look pass over to Karis. Karis penetrates in. Tipped it into Duhon and it goes out of bounds. Ball last touched by Cougars. It will be Kansas City ball. And a timeout is called. The coaches on CSU are not looking too happy. Or at least Coach Farr. I could read him pretty well. I could read him pretty well. He was like, what is that, man? So.
It hasn't gotten out of hand for CSU. I think that last play, if Eddie didn't slip, Kurt was on his way into the basket, but he just kind of shut it down on him.
Kanika, if you're Coach Richards, what are you telling the team? They're only down about 7 points, so of course they have plenty of time to turn it around.
Honestly, I would say guys, we're in a good position right now. You know, keep going to the basket, keep looking for your shots. If I look at Williams, I would say keep shooting. Tell Kersey, keep shooting. I would tell them the full court press is working. You know, make them turn over the ball and take it to our advantage and get buckets from it.
And Anthony, if you're Coach Dildy, I mean, they're only 7 points ahead. What are you telling them?
You know, get a little more aggressive. They're kind of stale. They're letting KC keep them out, you know, with the zone. I still say take it to them.
And with aggression, wouldn't you still be nervous that they're going to get too aggressive and then maybe, you know, get some fouls?
Well, that's when you have, you know, your timeout. I mean, it's 11:54 left. You know, you still got Pippen on the floor, and you can actually go back to how you started the game off. I haven't seen that offensively with the Cougars. So they still have some more moves they can look at.
And Quentin Pippen, no surprise, is the leading scorer for CSU with 17 points, followed behind.
Leading scorer of the game.
Is Clark Rosenberg with 9 points. And for Kansas City, no surprise there, leading scorer with 12 points is Harrison, followed by three people with 6 points. Kurtzy, Chapman, and Burke. Kansas City with the ball. Harrison is going to have the ball. Pass over to Kurtzy. Kurtzy back to Harrison. 20 seconds in the shot clock. Harrison trying to make something work here. Passes back over to Kurtzy. Kurtzy back to Harrison, who's open. Harrison takes a three-point shot, and it's good. That was a good look and a good play there by
a great design play. Mm-hmm.
Absolutely, by Kansas City.
And with Pippen on the bench, they need somebody out there that's going to take control of this game, you know, kind of calm the team down, tell them that, you know, guys, we're still okay. We're still, you know, ahead in this game. We're still in control of this game because right now Kansas City is controlling the tempo on the defense and the offensive end.
Absolutely. We're going to have Rosenberg inbound the ball to Karis. Karis tried to pass to Rosenberg, but it was stolen away by Kansas City. Hall tried to tip it up, but it was no good. Harrison takes possession of the ball.
In the hustle.
I told you something magical was coming up.
Just the hustle.
CSU has possession of the ball.
Oh. And as soon as I say somebody needs to step up on their team, Clark Rosenberg rises, literally rises to the occasion.
Oh, my goodness.
That was magical. I enjoyed it.
I'm trying to catch my breath. That was great. I didn't see it coming. That was nice. Rosenberg's going to inbound the ball for CSU with Hall on him. He looks and tries to find someone open. Kurt Karras completely open. Karras calling out the play here. Back to Rosenberg. Rosenberg's going to move around just a little, find Denard on the inside. Denard's going to pass out to Ross, who's open. Ross took the shot, and it's no good. And 54, that's the freshman, Kruger, over there with the rebound. Screening on Duhon. Kurtsey with the ball, inside pass to Williams Jr. Williams Jr. over to Kurtsey. Kurtsey was open. He took the shot, and it was no good. Rebound there by Matt Ross. Foul was called. That was a good call. I mean, they were all in his face. It was about three people there, so.
I thought they were going to get away. He thought he was going to get away with that one.
I thought they were, too. So that was a good call by the refs on that one.
The Ruse are going to put on this full-court press again, try to get them to turn over the ball.
I think this is going to be a crucial play. If CSU makes the basket, I think the tide has changed. And CSU would have the advantage. Wouldn't you agree, Kanika?
Yeah, I would think so because, you know, it's who's controlling the tempo.
CSU.
Which is, this is what they want them to do. The thing about it is when you're pressing, you have to slow down because they want to do that. They want to get out in the break.
They want to do that.
They want to turn. They want to make you turn the ball over, make the game ugly, turnover, so they can get fast break points.
And that was a great play there by Kansas City. We're going to have Hall at the line.
And see, this is when, right now, Dildy needs his senior leader, Quinton Pippen, to go out there and try to control this game. He just needs to, you know, Clark just needs to, you know, just calm down, you know, just relax and not try to push the ball so much.
Free throw by Hall is no good on that three-point play. And travel was called on Matt Ross, it seems.
Miscommunication. Two teammates
fighting
each other
for the same ball.
You know, and the Ruse, they need to use this to their advantage.
Current score is 50-46 in favor of CSU.
Down by two possessions.
9 minutes and 48 seconds left in the game. Kansas City has the ball. Williams Jr. takes the shot, and it's good. Two-point shot.
One possession game.
Duhon has possession of the ball.
Williams didn't see a shot go in until the second game when he had a bounce going for him. Since then, he has not missed a shot.
Duhon over to Pippen. Pippen passes out to Karras.
CSU needs a timeout. They need one of their players to control the game.
Absolutely.
They have to control the game.
Substitution taking Karras out and Pippen and putting in Muhammad and Clark Rosenberg. Harrison's going to bring the ball up the court for Kansas City. Rajon stands there with arms open, ready.
Like, come to my house.
Harrison tries to penetrate on the inside, shoots out to Williams Jr., who was all the way left open. Duhon with the rebound. Pushes it all the way to the basket, knocks it in, and is fouled, so a three-point play.
That's a great take right into the chest.
This is like a boxing match, you know? Yes. Someone's doing a rope-a-dope, and bam, they hit you under the chin.
A rope-a-dope?
Yeah.
I feel like if you're comparing it to that, it's like punch for punch at this point. Like, as soon as someone gets knocked down, the other person gets knocked down. It's kind of
right.
Just like no one is really just letting it. The free throw was no good by Duhon. No one's really just letting anyone take possession of the game.
Right.
Kurtsey with the ball has Denard and Duhon on him. He had to pass out to Hall, and Hall with a nice dunk there.
That was a good pass.
That was a great play by Hall. Great
okay,
pass.
Just to even it up, I give that a 7.0.
Yeah, great pass, split the trap, found the open man for the dump down.
Absolutely.
And it's only a 2-point game. The momentum is really in favor of Kansas City right
Absolutely.
Now.
Absolutely.
They're making the turnover the ball, and, you know, they're getting stops because they're steady cutting into this deficit, and they're only down by 2 points. And if I'm Kansas City, I'm feeling pretty good about where
exactly.
we stand right now.
Yeah, because, I mean, they've slowly been closing up that gap. Kansas City knew that they had so much time to work with, and they didn't necessarily have to come right in and steal it all at once. You know, they're taking their time adjusting to all the new players of CSU, and
you know,
it's clearly been working to their advantage, only down 2 points, like you said, one possession
yeah.
game.
And that's what it's about. You don't have to get it all at once. You know, Coach AJ always says, you know, just bit by bit, you know, media timeout by media timeout, go ahead and get it down. Continue to get it down, and you're going to slowly see that you're going to be in the game.
Rosenberg fakes and then passes over to Ross. Ross over to Pippen. Back to Rosenberg. Rosenberg has Williams Jr. on him.
See, and this is what they need. They need to run a play, you know, use the clock to their advantage.
Duhon takes the shot, and it's no good. Kurtsey with the rebound over to Harrison. Harrison penetrates inside and puts two on the board for Kansas City. Nice look there with, you know, he had two or three bodies on him.
And we have a tie game with 7 minutes and 55 seconds left in counting.
New ball game.
There you go. That's what ball is all about. Pippen takes a 3-point shot, and it's good. He heard you, Kanika. He said, not for long.
Rise to the occasion. Rise to the occasion.
And Kansas City, I'm betting, is going to come right back. Kurtsey with the ball over to Harrison. Harrison's going to work some of his little magic. Right back to Kurtsey. Kurtsey has Pippen in his face. Kurtsey had Matt Ross on him. Passes over to Harrison in the corner. Duhon doing a great job on him. Harrison loses the ball and gets it over to Williams Jr., and Williams Jr. knocks two on the board. Pippen with the ball for CSU. Kurtsey on him. Passes out to Rosenberg. Rosenberg's going to call out a play here with Williams Jr. in his face. Matt Ross is going to screen. Rosenberg to Pippen. Kurtsey on Pippen. Pippen.
Oh, yeah.
Nice
basket.
I feel like this is the fourth time that I've seen this play from CSU with different people. The ball is going up. They're being fouled, and they're turning it into, you know, these awesome plays.
You have to finish through contact. Finish
yes.
through contact, because at the end of the game, these three-point plays are going to what's going to count on the scoreboard.
Absolutely. Current score is now 57 of 54 with 6 minutes and 52 seconds left in the game. This is an exciting one, I must say.
Last couple of CSU games have been like that.
Absolutely. And it's only a 3-point game. Anthony, what are you telling your team if you're Coach Dildy?
You know, I would say, you know, play with heart, play tough, look for that open shot, stay focused, and just be there. Defensively, just be there.
And Kanika, if you're Coach Richardson?
I would say keep up the pressure, keep taking it to them, keep getting to the paint, and I would say really keep looking for Williams. Harrison and Williams, you know, keep shooting, keep going to the basket, and keep making them turn over the ball. But I would say on the defensive end, get stops. We got to get stops.
Absolutely. And once again, we would like to thank our sponsors, Weiss Orthopedics, Oaklawn Hilton, and Benton Hauser Chrysler Jeep Dealership. You like that, don't you?
Yeah. Along with Dodge.
Along with Dodge, yeah, of course. And our refs are Winston Stith, Ryan McDaniel, and Brad Fowler.
Your favorite ref, huh? He's
was
he's
that his name? Mr. Fowler,
Winston.
Shout out to you, okay? We love you here at CSU. And some brief updates. Chicago State is shooting 19 of 46 in field goals, 41%. Their three-point field goals are 5 of 15, 33%. And free throws are 14 of 17, which is pretty awesome, 82%. As Pippen puts down another free throw for CSU. And the is then taking out the game, you know, trying to substitute him.
Yeah, the strategy that Dilly's using is actually really smart. You know, he's making sure that he doesn't want to get Quinn Pippen his fifth foul. So, you know, he's keeping him in for like 2 minutes or so and taking him back out, which is smart.
Harrison with the ball. Nice look by Harrison, even though it wasn't
nice
totally completed.
Denard
with the rebound over to Duhon. Duhon tips it up. It's no good. Knocked out of bounds, and Denard hustled so hard to try to keep that ball alive. Just didn't work there. It's going to be Kansas City ball. Harrison's going to have the ball with Duhon in his face, and Hall right behind Duhon. Calling out the play here. 6 minutes left in the game. Hall's going to penetrate inside with Ross on him trying to block. And the ball went up, but it was no good. The foul was on Ross.
You know, and that's a good take. He went right into the chest of Matt Ross to draw mm-hmm. that foul.
Yeah. So Hall will go to the line. And that is the fifth team foul on Chicago State.
Matt's fourth.
Ooh, Matt's fourth.
So now you're put in a situation where your two of your best players are in foul trouble right now, which is in Kansas City. It's to your advantage.
Absolutely.
Take advantage of that. I would take it right to Pippen and Matt Ross.
Yeah, and now we're bringing in Pippen. So hey, let's just hope. If they are listening to us, they're either going to take our advice or not. But that's what I would do as Richardson. I know they're in foul trouble. Foul them out one more time. Get some actors on your team like we have at CSU. Matt Ross with the rebound. Over to Rosenberg. Rosenberg's going to bring the ball up the court. Over to Pippen. Pippen's going to penetrate inside, pass the ball to Denard. Denard went up,
that
but it was no good.
Two great blocks at
yes.
the rim.
Yes, Kansas
and
City.
And those are the stops that they need, and he just took his eye off of it.
Yeah.
He just took his eye off of it. But that is a great defensive stop by Kansas City.
And it's a three-point game, 58-55, 5 minutes and 51 seconds left. CSU possession. Pippen looking to find someone over Hall. Found Duhon. Duhon passed right back to Pippen. Pippen finds Rosenberg across the court. Rosenberg puts it up. It's no good. Denard with the second chance tips it in.
That is just
I couldn't believe there wasn't a foul.
That is just a hard put back.
Harrison with the ball. Kansas City over to Williams. Back to Bledsoe, back to Harrison. Harrison in the corner here. He's going to take the shot. It's no good. Rebound by Duhon. Duhon fast break over here. Puts up two himself.
Nice.
And Nate Duhon is as good as anybody in transition.
Yes,
he is that Euro step move or that behind the back move to his advantage. He can score in bunches on the fast break.
And, you know, I think that was a smart move there by Richardson. He started to realize that the gap was starting to widen back up. And like you mentioned, Duhon is starting to warm up himself, you know, and he wanted to kind of slow that down. The current score is 62-55, 5 minutes and 7 seconds left in the game.
Yeah, it's still a lot of time left. So, I mean, the game can go either way at this point. But
CSU just has to continue to get to the basket, you know, play as a team, knock down open shots, and Quentin Pippen and Matt Ross have to be smart and not foul this game, because they are really good assets to this team.
They're almost, you know, like kind of like the backbone. You kind of rely on them sometimes as the senior leadership. Pippen himself calls out the play as if he's the coach. You saw that, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sometimes you see stuff on the floor that your coach doesn't see on the sideline. So.
Yeah.
And just the feel for the game.
Bledsoe with the ball for Kansas City. Passes over to Williams. Out to Kurtsey. Kurtsey back to Bledsoe. Back to Kurtsey on the outside. Tried to shoot a three. No good.
Kurtsey's just having a really, really
rough game
today.
Rough.
You know, he's struggling, but I'm pretty sure down the stretch he'll rise to the occasion.
Denard with the ball over to Duhon. Over to Marcus Starks over here in this corner. Possession of the ball, CSU. Rosenberg calls out a play as Denard plans to screen him, but so Rosenberg loses the ball on the floor. Jump ball called.
And that is a great timeout call by Coach Dildy. He saw that, you know, Clark was going a little too fast and that it was a little out of control. So to call that timeout and save a possession with 4 seconds left, you know, this will really be a good possession for them if they can get a basket out of this.
That's a good look.
CSU looked to me like it was either miscommunication or they looked a little lost on that play.
Yeah. Seemed like they were trying to make something happen, but it just wasn't gelling. Everyone wasn't kind of coming together on the same note. So therefore, Dildy did a good thing in, you know, calling that timeout, regrouping the men, having them focus a little more. And the same thing, I'm sure, with Richards. Richardson's calling out a play there to his men. Rosenberg with the ball for CSU. Had Hall on him.
And I think that is it's third. That's a good sign that it's only his third foul.
And Muhammad will come in taking out Griffin. And you know, Griffin's a freshman too, and you wouldn't know that looking at him for the CSU team. He's been a great asset. He was the one that made those free throws in the New Mexico game, correct?
Right.
There you go.
Every time he came in, he had his hand in something.
Kansas City trying to bring it home. Tried to tip it in, but it was no good.
All right, Eddie.
Foul.
And that is the third offensive foul that Eddie Denard has created on the defensive end.
Yeah.
I was wondering if Matt Ross was going to come in, because now is the time that you put him in.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just, you know, no fear.
Yeah. You know, you need them in a game for it, especially when it's like a dead ball situation. Yeah, go ahead and go offense, defense. Just don't want to keep them in there for too long. When, like, 2 minutes, 3 minutes left in the game, you can keep him in and just trust that he knows that he should not foul or bail out of certain situations. Just let him have the basket.
And Matt Ross has the ball right now. Cross-court pass over to Duhon.
And I think we're in the bonus right now.
Foul is on number 10, Bledsoe. And that's the eighth team foul on the Ruse. Duhon will go to the free throw line, and we have Starks coming back in as well as Johnny Griffin. Duhon makes the first one. Still waiting for the second one. Quick substitution for Kansas City, bringing in Corver for Kansas City. Duhon's at the line. And second is good as well. Hall with the rebound. Over to Harrison. Harrison brings the ball up the court with Duhon in his face, calling out a play. Rosenberg attacks him. He passes over to Bledsoe. Bledsoe back to Harrison. Harrison has Duhon and Rosenberg on him, so he passes over to Korver. Korver finds Harrison. Harrison penetrates on the inside with four bodies on him, threw the ball up. And foul was called on Eddie Denard.
Harrison has been attacking. You would think that he's not as small as he is going in there with the big man, but he is fearless going in.
Like we said, Kanika, it's not always the size of the person.
It's not.
And Dildy over here seems to be communicating with the ref.
You know, as a coach, sometimes you think that referees call bad calls.
Oh, no, I know that for a fact. I've seen Jackson in the middle of the court.
Yeah, and as a player,
I know you know that.
As a player, you also think it.
Yeah, I'm sure. Because I've seen Jackson.
Check out the Cougar South Side over here.
Oh,
I don't know if this is like the song. I don't know what it is. Slow dancing. I don't know what it is. it's kind of cool. Okay, South Side over here getting it. with the Bruno Mars playing. It's always nice to have crowd interaction.
Absolutely. Great entertainment for everyone. Good job, Southside. How cute. Perfect for Valentine's Day.
That is cute. That is cute.
And some brief updates here. Chicago State is shooting 41%. 21 of 51 in field goals. 3-point shots are at 33%, and free throw shots are at still 85%. So they're doing amazing on free throws. Kansas City is shooting 52% on free throws, 21% on 3-point field goals, and 47% on regular field goals. We have Harrison at the line here. First shot is good for Kansas City. Current score is 64-56, 3 minutes and 40 seconds left in the game.
Have a 4-possession game here, guys.
Second one is no good. Good job by Ross to have that rebound. Rosenberg with the ball has Bledsoe and Hall on him. Cross court pass to what was supposed to be Duhon.
That was a great
perfect
save
for
Eddie.
Yeah, for Denard to save that pass over to Pippen.
He was just cutting back door and like, oh, look what's here.
Yeah, Pippen over to Rosenberg. Rosenberg is going to penetrate inside himself
good
and
pass
to Denard.
Nice
That's
pass.
A really good pass.
Good assist by Clark Rosenberg. Found his big man. Kansas City second chance was good there. Number 21, Chapman. Knocked two on the board for Kansas City. Rosenberg here. Was trying to bring the ball up the court. Foul was called.
You know, and Clark Rosenberg is a great asset to have on the team just because he really is, you know, a scoring, like, two guard. But he can also play the point. He can bring the ball up. Mm-hmm. And he's big. He's, like, 6'4", so he's really a great asset to have on your team.